Hi, I'm Caleb Bradford from Princeton University.
Hi, I'm Kim Mahung from Naval Technical College.
We're on the campus of Marshall Space Flight Center. This is where America's manned spaceflight program started over 50 years ago.
We are two out of about 150 students who are from around America who are spending this summer in a life-changing intern program.
I'm Kathleen Bernhard from Georgia Tech.
And I'm Hisham Ali from the University of Alabama.
Marshall really is the engineering backbone of NASA, among other things. The Marshall Center designed and built the Saturn V rocket, which uses engines like these to send man to the moon.
Marshall's past engineering responsibilities have been many, including the Lunar Rover and Skylab, our first space station. Also, Marshall was the lead developer on the Space Shuttle main engine propulsion system, including the SSME behind us, as well as the solid rocket boosters and the external fuel tank.
I'm Candace Rice from Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University.
And I'm Jesus Trillo from the University of Texas at El Paso.
Marshall went on to manage and operate Space Lab, the science lab that flew on shuttle and then built modules of the International Space Station, and to this day manages the science activities that occur here on board 24/7.
Marshall also managed the development of the Hubble Space Telescope, the Chandra X-ray Telescope, and is now working with the James Webb Space Telescope.
I'm Doug Hall from Vanderbilt University.
And I'm Elizabeth Chen from MIT.
The biggest undertaking at Marshall now is the Space Launch System, or SLS. This will be the most powerful rocket ever built and will provide opportunities to explore the Moon, asteroids, and Mars.
Wherever you spend your Marshall Summer Intern Program, you learn a lot about NASA, Marshall Space Flight Center, the Huntsville community, and the history and the future of America's space program.
Oh, this summer internship has been amazing. It's meant a lot to me, both professionally and just as a matter of personal interest. So, as a pre-med student, basically a requirement at this stage is that you have to do a lot of undergraduate research. And as far as research goes, when you say that you worked for NASA and did research for NASA, that just sticks in people's heads. So I've been working with a microbial electrolysis cell. So basically what the cell will do in the future is it eats carbon dioxide that you exhale and things like that. So it lowers cabin carbon dioxide levels. The cell could also theoretically make an arbitrary organic product that you tell it to, whether that's a bioplastic or a medicine called granulocyte colony stimulating factor, which is used to treat radiation exposure. But unfortunately, the shelf life of that medicine is really small compared to things like a trip to Mars. So you can't just take it with you. What you have to do almost is find a way to make it, which you could do with this cell that I'm experimenting with.
So I'm here with the NASA Robotics Academy, which is a really great program because it introduces you to NASA as a whole and gets you to understand how NASA works. So I'm working in a team of three people, and the three of us have been working on building a new set of air-bearing vehicles for the Marshall Flat Floor Facility, which is the flattest floor in the world. With the Robotics Academy, we've also gotten to travel to Kennedy Space Center and the Jet Propulsion Lab in California and see the work that's being currently done there, which has also been very exciting.
I've benefited tremendously from this program, both professionally and technically. I've had the opportunity to work with a world-class facility with world-class experts in my field. I had been involved in rapid prototyping for a long while. Our focus really is for sustainable in-space manufacturing. And one of the ways that we can do that is through additive manufacturing, or what is commonly known as 3D printing. And so, you know, just the possibility to contribute to something much larger than myself, something that could actually make sustainable moon-based development a reality, was really exciting.
Oh my gosh, this is a life-changing experience for me. I've never thought I would be here. I am barely starting out learning the program. It's Dalmia that I was really working on, learning how to program robots, specifically to learn how robots will change in movement and rotation, everything from gravity to no gravity. What I heard from the instructors back home is that they will be learning Dalmia themselves, and so it's just a great experience where I will know what they're talking about already and how to help other people and how to make it easier for everybody else to learn it.
My first recommendation is apply. If you don't apply, you will never get an internship. Apply and be optimistic, be confident that you're going to get the internship. That's what I did. I'm working on the propulsion systems department. I have been disassembling the F1 gas generator valve. We changed the seals, we checked their conditions, and I just learned so much. For example, I have seen a lot of thermodynamics and system dynamics and thermofluids, and I haven't taken those classes. So I have learned a lot from it, and I know when I go back to school, I'm gonna be more than ready for it.
The internship that I'm in is the NSTI internship that's dealing with science and technology. And I've gained so much with just these 2 months that I've been here. And I would recommend it to anyone. Having an internship basically leaves a very good impact on your life. And the relationships that you make here travel with you forever. Within the Office of OSAC, that's Office of Strategic Analysis and Communications, we conduct different tours. And we're having congressional interns that are coming to visit Marshall. And we will basically inform them on the great things that are happening here at Marshall. Marshall is exceptionally cool. Like, I've done so many things, and I'm very, very grateful for this internship. I was able to travel to D.C. and actually meet the administrator, Charlie Bolden, and that was amazing. I've met different astronauts, and I've had a chance to see the actual background of Marshall as a whole.
So I was an intern 2 years ago, and this year I'm back with the NASA Academy program. So I've been looking at the dust production of comets. So comets, they produce dust. That's what gives them their tail-like structures. And what's interesting is that their dust production changes with time. And we don't really understand those mechanisms too well. So what I've been doing is I've been monitoring three comets over the summer and seeing how their dust production changes. My mentors and I, produced a small publication 2 years ago, but we're working on another publication kind of in a higher level journal this summer. And I don't know if I would have had that same experience in other internships.
I've been working with a program called POST, a program to optimize simulated trajectories. It's one of the programs my division uses to do 3 degree of freedom trajectories. I've just been learning how to use the program so that I can join my mentor in working with the trajectories for SLS. What do I think makes a successful intern? The willingness to explore and learn more about things you may have never even heard of before.
I've been wanting to work for NASA since I was a little kid. When I was 6 years old, my teacher pulled out a globe and was like, "This is the Earth. Let me teach you about the other planets." And I was mesmerized. I loved every minute of it. I ran home screaming, "Mommy, Daddy, I want to go to space. This is the coolest thing ever." And then they told me about NASA, and I'm like, I'm working there. My love for space turned into a love of physics, which turned into a love of engineering, the practical application of this. And it's really what made me want to become an engineer and do something that for the greater cause of sending people to space.
So I would definitely recommend NSTRF. NSTRF stands for NASA's Space Technology Fellowship, and I'm part of the inaugural class, which first year it was implemented was in 2011. NSTRF is really for graduate students. So NASA is really seeking for individuals who show potential towards fulfilling goals for NASA's strategic missions and challenges. For example, we're working on lightweight, high-strength cryotanks, one of the first in the world. So I've been able to apply the research that I've been working on over the course of the year towards a real-world application, and you will not get that anywhere else.
With the work that I'm doing here, I had an opportunity to submit an abstract to the International Astronautical Congress, which is a conference that's held in Naples, Italy this year. The Vice President of Research at the University of Alabama in Huntsville is sponsoring any student that gets accepted as a main author into the main symposium. I submitted this paper with my mentor at NASA and it got accepted. So I'm also writing the paper for the conference. The US is gonna be there, all the NASA centers, you name it, MIT, Caltech, all the big names and all the little names. We're all gonna be there, so I'll have a chance to talk to them about all the work that I've been doing, and it's kind of a big stress, but I have 15 minutes to present and 5 minutes of Q&A, so I better be ready.
Our intern coordinators, Mona and Tina, have done a great job of having us, you know, get acclimated to the city and providing many opportunities for us to go out and see, you know, how Marshall contributes to the community at large. And then all we have to offer here so far is jobs and research opportunities. There is no part of my internship and my time here that I have regretted and I have wished, you know, spent somewhere else. It's been incredible to, one, see the city, which is growing and just full of things to do and full of interesting people from all across the world. And then, again, just to be able to, I guess, get your hands dirty, as they say a lot of times, with your field, to get a feel for, like, what you want to do in life and the opportunity to network and to meet others like yourself. It's unbelievably amazing to feel that. And, yeah, there's no one who wouldn't enjoy this opportunity.
A unique feature of the internship program at NASA Marshall Space Flight Center is our poster expo. At the end of the 10 weeks, our interns have an opportunity to present their work, highlight their research at a poster expo that we have here at Marshall. The purpose and the intent is to provide students the opportunity to enhance their presentation skills that they can use in the future, whether at a professional conference, at a meeting at school. It's an opportunity to learn, really. But as an incentive, we've been fortunate to have Lockheed Martin provide prize awards so that it gives an added benefit to doing your best work. And that's what we hope to showcase when we have our poster expo.